Rebecca Costa, how is complexity killing Wall Street?
Well, it's obvious that things have gotten so complicated that we no longer understand what is going on in the financial markets. Things are beginning to hit us very, very quickly, and we don't see them coming. In some instances, such as the euro or the largest financial institutions in the world, they're just admitting they didn't know how they were making their money. They didn't understand the risk and exposure they had taken on.
Well, I guess one good recent example of that is JP Morgan's CEO, Jamie Dimon, didn't know what was going on over in London, lost $2 billion and counting. But can you go back? Can you have a Volcker rule which breaks up the big banks and dumb ourselves down to a certain extent?
Actually, history indicates that there's no going back. What happens is complexity exponentiates as a society moves forward. It reaches a point at which things are more complex than we have evolved to be able to physiologically handle. So if you think about it, there are two clocks. One, the pace at which we make new discoveries, we adopt new technologies, and then another clock, which is the rate at which this biological spacesuit can evolve new capabilities, in this case, cognitive capabilities.
So what's the end game in all this? We're just going to keep having these technological advances till we melt down, another flash crash or another 2008 meltdown, if you will?
Well, if you look back over the Mayan, Roman, Khmer, Ming empires, you see that there's a convergence that occurs. Eventually, things are so complex that the society becomes gridlocked. It knows what its worst problems and threats are, but it's unable to get on top of them. But the second phase is the most dangerous one. Things become so complex that we begin substituting facts with unproven beliefs. And at that point, policy and decisions become irrational.
Does it also create a divide in society where you have those with the firepower, the technology, to keep up with the complexity? I don't know if it's the high-speed traders when you're talking about the market, as opposed to the individual traders who are dropping out because of all this complexity?
You would think so, but it doesn't really work that way, because even in the Bernie Madoff situation, you had very sophisticated investors turning over a good portion of their savings to this person, and those were not mom and pops. Those are people that had been in the market a long time. So this is that point at which we can't distinguish facts from unproven beliefs, and we become susceptible to false prophets.
So the individual investors are already dropping out of the market. So do you think that the smartest investors are going to give up as well? Is that the end game for this?
We have to understand that we've entered a high failure rate environment. And effectively, each of us that's investing has become a venture capitalist. We have to develop models where we're prepared to have high losses, but the gains will dwarf the losses. So in the case of a venture capitalist, they might be investing in 100 companies and only expect 10 or 15 to do well. But where I come from in California, the venture capitalists seem to be doing really well using that strategy.
But unfairly so, is it because they have the firepower, they have the technological know-how?
Well, technology you would think would help you, but at a certain point, having a million options is the same as having none. The human brain simply can't process that many options, so that there's a certain point at which additional information and additional technology don't help you. Verizon's got a new phone out right now, and they're claiming you can put 200,000 apps on it. Well, I got news for us. We can't handle 200,000 of anything.